Hello everyone and welcome to another After Effects tutorial. My name is Tyler Bradway and this is Creativid Studios. Today I'm going to be showing you how to make a motion graphics film burn effect in After Effects that looks like this. And it's really simple to do. It'll take you probably like 5 minutes to do it. It's not hard at all. So let's just hop into the tutorial. Let's make a new composition. Name it Luma. Make a solid, Command Y, hit enter. And make sure it's the comp size, obviously. Fractal noise, we'll just drag that on. And next, change the fractal type to dynamic progressive, the noise type to spline, and increase the contrast to like 300. Decrease the complexity to 3.5. And increase the scale to like 200. Next, hit a keyframe next to brightness, hit U on your keyboard, and decrease the brightness until it's all black. Go to 1 second, increase the brightness till it's all white. So now we have this. So because there's this gradient, we want to get rid of that so that it's just not going to be partially transparent for the Luma mat. So we'll use posterize, drop that on, make it 2 for the value, and bring it into a new composition, and we'll rename this transition. So we have this. I'm gonna decrease the complexity a little bit. Maybe increase the scale. Okay, so back in the transition pre-comp, transition composition, we'll add a new text layer or whatever layer you want to transition. It could be a logo, it could be anything. So we'll just type in something. Next, we can just align this using the align panel and put it below the Luma mat and set it as a Luma mat. And it appears. And I'm actually not liking the duration, so I'm just gonna pull it out further in the pre-comp. And let's take a look. Go to your project panel, pull the transition composition into a new composition, and we're going to add a fill effect. It can be whatever color you want. I'm going to go to the first frame and just trim it up. I'm just going to choose a color and then duplicate it, choose another color. Duplicate that, choose another color, duplicate that, and choose another color. So now, if we offset them in time, with the most offset one being at the top, so we get something like this, we get that. So we just offset, you can change the amount you offset them to get different effects, but I like one frame at like 30 frames a second. So that's what you get. And we can go further and make it transition out. All we have to do is take this second transition, pull it into a new comp. Next, take the Luma mat and put that above this layer, change the mat type to inverted Luma mat and go to where you want it to fade out. Duplicate these two layers, select the bottom two, and offset them one frame, add a fill on the bottom most layer, and just change the color again. Duplicate again, offset, and change the color. So now, this is what we have. That's it for this tutorial, guys. If you want to find more tutorials like this one, you can check out my channel, Creativid Studios. There are more tutorials like this one there. And if you subscribe, after you press that button, make sure to click the bell icon to be notified when I upload new videos. For some reason, the new YouTube doesn't automatically notify you. You have to actually click that bell. Like this video for more, and I'll see you guys next time.